In this video, I will show you how to DIY a simple and powerful 12-volt to 240-volt inverter with the easy steps. This is IC chip of TL494 with 18 pins. Those are diodes, resistors of different values, and various capacitors. This is a mini breadboard, and those parts will be soldered on the board. This is the circuits diagram of TL494 frequency oscillator, and the parts values are clear marked. Here we go. A simple frequency oscillator has been made. This is the IC chip of TL494. That is the 10k ohms resistor. These are the capacitors with a value of 0.69F combined. That is the 16k ohms resistor. The 2.2k ohms resistor is right over here. Two diodes of 1N4007 are used here instead of the 1. And two capacitors connected in series belong to here in the circuit. This red wire is for DC positive, such as 12 volt. That black wire is for DC negative or ground. Blue wire is the oscillator's output terminal 9. And so output terminal 10 is white wire. That's it. Incidental speaking, this formula is for the oscillator's frequency calculation. It is determined by the 16k ohms resistor and 0.69 μF capacitor in this case. So the oscillator's frequency is 50 Hz. Now a multimeter is selected to DC position. Its positive probe is connected to the blue wire, which is the oscillator's output terminal 9. Its negative probe is connected to battery's negative terminal, and together with the black wire, which is the oscillator's ground. As shown in the circuits diagram, connecting the oscillator's red wire to battery's positive terminal, the multimeter indicated just over 5 volt. And that's good. The multimeter's positive probe is connected to the oscillator's white wire now. Which is the oscillator's output terminal 10, shown in the circuits diagram. Connecting red wire to battery's positive terminal. The multimeter indicated over 5 volt as well, and all good. That oscillator will become a frequency generator for the DIY inverter. The other parts are a DIY transformer, which are 240 volt this side, and center tapped, 11 volt that side. A switch is here for DC power on and off. Two resistors, which their value are 275 ohms and 3/4 watt each. Two resistors again, their values are 100 ohms and 1/4 watt each. A resistor with combination values of 36k ohms and 12 watt. An oscillator or frequency generator made a few minutes ago. A set of MOSFETs with a heat sink attached. Two MOSFETs of IRF3205. And one more set is here. A set of batteries positive, negative alligators. and cables. All parts and components here will make a DIY, simplified DC 12-volt to AC 240-volt inverter possible. These parts have been soldered together and bolted on a piece of the board. The drain terminals of MOSFETs for that set soldered and connected together with their heatsink. And so did this set. The source terminals of all MOSFETs soldered together with this common ground, or batteries negative. Two of 100 ohms resistors are here. And two of 275 ohms resistors are there. The oscillator, or frequency generator, will be there, in the middle. The DIY transformer will be here on the board. The 36k ohms resistors will be there, next to transformer. The DC power switch will be here on the board. The positive and negative alligators cables will be fixed somewhere convenient on the board. Now the parts and components have been bolted and secured on the board. Batteries positive and negative alligators cables are here. The DIY transformer, which had centered tap side as primary, is here. And its secondary terminals, which produce AC 240-volt voltage, are right here. These terminals will be connected to a multi-socket set. The oscillator or frequency generator is at the bottom on the board. One set of MOSFET's drain terminals are bolted on their heatsink, which also bolted together with one of transformer's primary terminal. And so done with other primary terminal. The wire between the DC power switch to the transformer's center tap terminal is here. And the common ground is connected to battery's negative alligator cable. This is the multi-socket set, connecting it to AC 240-volt terminals, and make sure secured. The setup for actual running is here. The DIY inverter. The socket set has been plugged in the load, as one globe, and a fan from recycled microwave oven. A multimeter with AC voltage position, and 12-volt battery connected. Switched the DC power on, the globe lighten, and the multimeter indicated AC 242-volt. Switched the fan on, and multimeter indicated AC 240-volt. Now more globes have been plugged in the socket set. Total are 4 globes. First, switched one globe on. Then the fan on. Lastly, rest of globes on. They are working well, and the multimeter indicated AC 240-volt, and all good. That's it. Now you've known how to DIY an inverter with rating of DC 12-volt to AC 240-volt. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.